In 2004, I spent some time in Kenyan refugee camps. These refugees were from Uganda and had been uprooted as they fled from the LRA. They recruited 5,000 children into the Ugandan rebel army. My role was not to explore the LRA itself, but the issues related to attachment by families that were resettling in Kenya. As we spent time in these refugee camps, we compiled stories about the struggle for people to attach to a new place. The issue we investigated was called the displacement effect. The displacement effect is the influence that an extended season of being uprooted has on the process of rooting. This exploration has made me acutely aware of the signs and symptoms of people staying suspended above a place. Now, in no way do I want to minimize those displaced by war, but I do think we are experiencing a version of displacement here in the West. I believe the rigorous pursuit of self-actualization generates this hunt for the ideal job, the ideal partner, the ideal status, the ideal education, which unintentionally creates atrophy in these muscles that are necessary for rooting. What does it mean to root in a particular neighborhood with a particular people? The incarnation of God in Christ models for us an intentional rooting into a place. Now grasp this, that Jesus immersed into the Nazareth neighborhood for 30 years. This is God with us. How do we draw our community into a real-time place? How do we move from being detached to being attached? We cannot stay suspended above the relational labyrinth in our towns and cities. We need a fresh way to orient ourselves as disciples on a daily, weekly, monthly basis that leads to local listening and presence. What is birthed out of this is the neighborhood rooting tool. This acts as a primary tool for practical, ongoing, incremental presence in a neighborhood. At V3, we've arranged 4 place connectors to equip a missional community to build a rhythm. The first is province. A province is a manageable section of our city we take ownership of. We must shape our location devotion, seeking out who is already doing good work in that province. What is beautiful in our province? What is broken in this place? Who are the marginalized within this province? Number 2 is porch. The porch is symbolic of our literal residence. We seek to use our front stoop, our lawn chair, our barbecue, our sidewalks, our front lawn. Understanding that we invite the other into our homes, we're inviting Jesus into our home. Do I see my home through the lens of protective security or sacred hospitality? What are my fears associated with home generosity? Number 3 is pathways. Our pathways are the regular routes we take. What roads and routes do we want to use to encounter those in our neighborhood? Do we walk? Do we drive? Do we bike? How do we move into astute listening along our pathways? And number 4 is pivots. Pivots are where we park, where there's a relational intersection that occurs. Are you a regular there? Have you made introductions? Are you seeking to build bridges at that place? It doesn't matter whether you're new to a location or you've been living somewhere 20 years, this neighborhood rooting tool will plummet your missional community into the beauty and brokenness in a place, drawing you into incarnational presence.